Dr. Vijay, working as an associate professor in Electronics and Communication Engineering, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering. Welcome to Digital System Design Laboratory. In this session, we are going to discuss about full adder as well as full subtractor by using VHDL behavioral style of modeling.
See, this is the full adder code. Here I have used the behavioral style for developing the logic of this full adder. Here A, B and C are the primary inputs of this full adder. S and C out, these two signals are actually output pins for this full adder. And in this architecture body, inside process, I have included the input variables A, B and C in. Whenever any event occurs for this A, B and C in, the following code will execute. Here S is nothing but the sum expression and its mathematical equation is A XOR B XOR C in. And for the carry out, we have used the pin C underscore out. See, the corresponding mathematical equation is AB plus C into AXRB. And for this particular logic, now let us validate the response by using its corresponding timing diagrams, for which we are doing the analysis similar to the previous methods. Just click on run simulation, run behavioral simulation. Now one pop-up window will open and which helps us to provide its corresponding inputs so that we can evaluate the outputs. See, A, B, C in are the primary inputs, S and C out are the output pins which are actually initially unassigned state. Now I am going to assign by using force clock. Here I am taking it as binary. Leading edge 0, trailing edge 1, period 100 nanoseconds. And whereas for the B, the same binary data type with the 0 and 1 trailing and leading edges, the time period is 200 nanoseconds. Whereas for C in, the same kind of binary, 0, 1 trailing and leading edge, but its time period should be double to the B, nothing but 400 nanoseconds. Now if we do the simulation, yes, see, this is its corresponding output waveforms. We know these are the 8 possible test cases. See, when all the inputs are assigned as zeros, nothing but A is 0, B is 0, C is 0, we are getting the same 0 for both sum as well as the carry out. And here we can see its corresponding truth table, that is for 0, 0, 1, we are getting sum. Means for the first 4 cases, the sum acts like the XOR, it is like 0, 1, 1, 0, according to its table. And for the remaining 4 cases, it acts like the XNOR 1001. See, this is for the sum output, whereas the carry out, it is AND gate for the first 4 combinations of inputs. See here, initially it is 000 and next 1, it acts like the AND gate. For the next 4, it acts like the OR gate. Okay, that is what we have seen in the truth table of the full adder. It is 0, 111 for the carry out. So with this, I can conclude the working functionality of the full adder. Now let us see the full subtractor, and the same kind of logic I am using for this full subtractor, but its mathematical expression for the borrow out is different, whereas the difference is expressed similar to the sum expression in the full adder. See, in this full subtractor code, here I have considered the inputs as A, B and borrow input, which is represented with B in, and outputs are difference represented as D and borrow out is B underscore out signal. For the D, the corresponding inputs are A XOR B XOR B in, and for B out, the expression is A bar B plus, see it is like the borrow in and A XNOR B. See, this is the logic for the full subtractor, and now let us do the same kind of analysis for validating its output. See, here I am assigning the inputs similar to that of full adder, and for B also I am assigning with respect to the clock itself. Here the period I am doubling, and for borrow in 2 the same way, binary leading and trailing edges are 0 1, and the time is, considering it as 400 nanoseconds as the period, and if we do the simulation, see this is the corresponding output sequences of the full subtractor. If we observe the same See, it acts like, means for the first four combination, it acts like the XOR function. See, it is 0, 1, 1, 0. Next one is 1, 0, 0, 1. Whereas for borrow out, it acts like whenever the combinations, if you observe here, 0, 1, 0, see, it is 0 minus 1, we are going to get the difference as the 1, and 1 minus 0, the same 1 we are getting for the D. While coming into this borrow out, 0 minus 1, we are getting the extra pin, that is for borrow out. See, this way we can observe the corresponding outputs of the full subtractor.
With this, I can conclude the coding of full adder as well as full subtractor by using VHDL behavioral style of modeling. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.